In this video, we're going to talk about how to animate a camera move in Storyboard Pro. The first thing we can do is examine the differences between the stage view and the camera view. The stage view gives us a fixed point of view of our scenes. If we animate the camera, we can see the camera moving around inside of the stage view. The camera view is exactly that. It shows us what the camera sees. Use each of these views as needed to help arrange the elements within your scenes. So first we need to kind of position the camera. Let's click our camera tool from our toolbar, and you'll notice a little black handle has appeared in the middle of our scene. If I click and drag that, it moves the position of our camera. Clicking and dragging the upper left corner allows us to play with the zoom level of our camera, and clicking and dragging the bottom corners allows us to change the rotation of our camera. And if we got our camera to a position where we're not happy with, we want to put it back where we found it, we can go up to camera, we can go down to reset camera, and that will reset it. It will put it back to its original position. So now let's add a very basic camera pan to this scene as our character Jacko is just kind of tossing the football up and down in his hand. Very simple animation in the animatic here. And we're going to just kind of focus here on this scene here. So we can add some keyframes to our timeline in a few ways. First way we can do it is by going down to the camera here in our timeline, and we can click this little plus, and that will add a new keyframe for wherever our timeline is. We can hit undo. We can also right click in here and add a camera keyframe at the beginning of the panel. And if we right click, we can add a camera keyframe at the current frame. And we can also add a camera keyframe at the end of the panel. Just some quick handy options. I'm going to undo all of those. I will just go to the beginning. I'll add a keyframe there. And you'll notice now that once I add a keyframe, our handles have turned green. That's letting us know that we've added some keyframes to our camera. And I'm going to go to the very end of my scene here, because I want my pan to last across the entirety of my scene. I'll add another keyframe by clicking here. And these little arrows here, left and right, just go to the next available keyframe or previous keyframe. You can also just select them within the timeline. So let's just add a little bit of a drift. So let's move our camera slightly to screen left, and I'm holding down shift to constrain it so that it just moves like so. I'm going to go to my last keyframe, I'm going to select it, and again I'm going to hold down shift, and I want this to be just a drift. I don't want it going very far, so let's see how that looks. Just a little bit. I hit play, and it just gives us a little drift, just a little something to give the scene a little life. Right now I have something right up here called the camera mask. That's this black area around it. You can add yours on and off by going down here in the camera view and just toggling it on and off as you need. I'll turn it off for 1 second. If I go here, I'm going to drag this out really far. You'll see that Storyboard Pro is adding in some arrows for us, giving us a visual indication of which direction our camera move is moving in. So I'm going to undo that. I have little tiny ones so you couldn't see them. Since my camera move is tiny, I'm going to turn my camera mask back on. We can also reset the position of a particular keyframe. Because at this point now, since I have some animation going on here, if I go back up to my camera and want to reset my camera like we spoke about previously, if I hit reset camera, pay attention, all of my keyframes get deleted. Let's undo. If I want to just reset a particular keyframe, select that keyframe, go up to camera, and choose reset the selected camera keyframe, and that will put that particular keyframe back to its original position. And again, this is a very slight drift, just something to give the scene a little life. And again, we can move the position and retime our camera moves by clicking and dragging around. We can select multiple ones and drag them around as well. I've held shift down to select. So that's how we can retime our camera. And notice I can't go beyond this particular scene. a camera move is tied to its particular scene, so we cannot go beyond. One thing that's kind of helpful when we are retiming is using the snapping option. Right now, I believe mine is off. So let me zoom out to help illustrate this point a little better. If I click my keyframe and move it around, it kind of will move where I put it, where I let go. But if I click on snapping, it'll snap to the edges of a panel, helping me find a timing if I wish to snap to a particular panel. That may be useful for you. Turn mine off and zoom back in. Just hitting 1 and 2 on my keyboard. And as we retime our animatics and our camera moves, Storyboard Pro offers a few ways of keeping our camera moves in sync. So right now I have mine set to none. And we can go to that by right-clicking, going to Camera Keyframe Sync Mode, or going up to Camera Keyframe Sync Mode. Same thing. And right now I have mine set to none, which means if I move the duration of this scene or this panel, the keyframe stays put. Undo. If I change my keyframes sync to relative to the panel, that means if I change the duration of a particular panel, Storyboard Pro will try and keep it relative to that panel. So let's go to this panel in particular right here. I'm going to put this keyframe, I'm going to eyeball this, I'm going to put it right in the middle of this particular scene, of this particular panel right here. And since I have chosen relative to panels, if I change the duration of this panel, Storyboard Pro will try and keep it exactly where it can relative to its original space and time. The third option is relative to scene. Same concept, but applying it to the entirety of the scene. So I will eyeball this once again, since these frames are not precise. I'll put my camera move in smack dab in the middle of my entire scene. And if I change the duration of the scene, Storyboard Pro will try and put it where it found it in relationship to the whole of the scene. So those are a few ways of animating the camera inside of Storyboard Pro.